An elf in tattered red robes.
So many sus.
A floorboard.
What are you doing, elf? Trying to get a drop?
I'm no elf. Don't you call me that. Seven.
My own magister. Three magisters vanished so far, all within Driftwood. That's what I'm.
I have to keep investigating. Keep the.
You do that.
Throw him in a hole for all.
A prim woman in a starched apron wipes a glass with a clean rag. She pins you with blue, steel-sharp eyes as you...
Blessings upon our Lucian.
Fine, I'll have a bowl of the house stew if you... Oh, after all I...
He lowers his gaze, his lip.
It's my... No.
No, and the waiter won't even bring me...
Ah.
Tell me, how are you with, well...
Ah, oh, to my mentor. It made short work of Liam. May the gods rest in...
Now, I can't tell...
The elf beckons you as she comes and thrusts...
I'd do without you.
Yeah? You're good with the magisters caging anyone up.
He fixes you with a
snare. Greetings, stranger. Looking to ease the pain of a decaying world.
He purses his lips. His fingers drum a pattern on his elbow. A lascivious.
Let me ask you this. Across the world, who is. I'm being beaten at my own game here. But after yourself, lizards are the world's greatest lovers. And for a minuscule fee, I can direct you to the world's most talented. The price.
The money that.
Now, let me ask you this. Upstairs.
He gives you a. The spirit of a magister.
My ring.
The
sp- I should have been more.
This towards the kitchen. This, but it doesn't. The spirit.
I was.
The spirit. The
spirit.
Curiosity kills the cat, or gets it sent to Fort Joy. You're willing to risk Fort Joy for one night with a
The town is poor, but this-
A weathered woman-
The bell rings a wall. The ship is a- And yet, perhaps-
She'd bear-
Make-
A ghostly-
Spoke to the lady captain, didn't ya? I seen ya, elf. I'm doing my duty here, I am. And I'm on duty here.
He blinks one. He raises a finger. She babbles.
My ears are and I have that accursed bell lies. The compass surely lies. Let me mark your chart. But
you're willing to risk Fort Joy for one night with a lizard? Then you're an idiot.
With a dip of her head. Weathered and rugged. The chest won't. It doesn't open. It doesn't budge.
Speak the word. And I speak. You speak.
For your.
The lock unlocked.
Train your eyes on my treasures, not my person.
Yes,
but... Curiosity kills the cat. It's the scent of Fort Joy. You're willing to risk Fort Joy for one night with a lizard? Then you're an idiot.
Thank you.
not a pick you can trust.
You got that right, Hilga. You got that right.
I am Baron Lavere. I am Baron Lavere, not he. An impostor, jewel murderer, thief, a rival, but it matters. You who hears the lament, please. When one's in a small... Have you a reason for barging into my room, madam?
Which is what killed the cat, remember?
Still, no harm done, I suppose.
As you approach the silken robe noble, Ifan does a double take and laughs in recognition. He pulls you to one side.
I know this man. And he's not at all what he seems.
Ifan bounds forward and embraces the man, all effusive greetings. As they part, talking animatedly, the man's beard slips sideways down his face. He's wearing a disguise. They chatter away for some time. Using a guttural cant, you struggle to understand. At one point, the man says something and looks over at you intently. Ifan waves his hand and laughs. The man hunkers down and seems to be sketching a rough map on the floor, using an apple, some playing cards, and a fistful of threads pulled up from the carpet. Ifan claps the man on the back and turns to leave.
Well, now we know the way to the sawmill. And we know Roost thinks I'm bringing you there as part of the Godwoken contract. Roost's camped out at the sawmill.
So, Roost is at a sawmill. Let's pay him a visit.
She smiles. Her eyes
must be an awful lot of fun toys to be had at a sawmill.
Well now, how's my favorite Godwoken?
What the devil are you staring at?
His eyes glitter as he stands tall to tell the story.
So, underneath the tavern in Driftwood, there's a place I feel right at home. A delightful little hive of scum and villainy. A few months back, I was relaxing down there after a job. Just a hint of Drudenay, you know, a hint. All of a sudden, a tiger prowls in. I jump up, but everyone else is just ignoring it. And then he picks up my scent. His eyes turn blue, and he leaps to pounce on me, a fury of claws and teeth. I flip the table and start scrambling for my crossbow, nowhere to be found. And by now, the tiger's right on top of my eyeballs. So I do the only thing I can think of. I summon Afrit, my soul wolf. And now everybody reacts. Screaming, scrambling around, pelting for the stairs, drinks flying everywhere. And that pesky tiger? Nowhere to be seen. Turns out it was Drudenay messing with me. Stronger stuff than I'm used to. Also turns out some people don't appreciate spectral wolves tearing up the place. So some people called magisters on me. Well, it's guarded by a grouchy-seeming dwarf named of Papa Thrash, but he's a real sweetheart once you get to know him. I love that password of his, open minds and closed fists.
This room is temperate enough, is it not?
An old lone wolf colleague of mine in disguise, Callow. He's hunting Godwoken, but don't worry. I didn't tell him our little secret. Poor fellow'd have an attack of the bloody flux if he knew what was really going on.
Should I check the cupboards for ogres? That's quite all right.
Ifan bites his lip and laughs.
That'll be tough for you to say without any teeth. But be my guest. Give it a whirl. Don't worry. I'm not going to hand you in for the bounty. Sure, you could do the very same to me. I think we should know who hunts us and why. Just play it cool. We go in, we get answers, we leave. Nothing more to it than that.
From the glint in his eye and the wicked smile he...
All right. It has the potential to get messy. Very messy indeed. but I've got your back if you've got mine.
Ifan raises an eyebrow and folds his arms.
Of course I'm afraid of things. Heights, the dark, even spiders, truth be told. I just do things anyway. The fear doesn't go away, but my body is used to the rush by now. Keep going long enough and, well, the intensity is how you know you're alive.
Perhaps I could go downstairs for a bit of stew?
No. No. Heard of. Yes. He's got a lot of pets. I heard he takes them as souvenirs after every contract he fulfills. But I'll be honest with you, I don't ask too many questions about why. I don't, want to know. I'm from the deserts of Mezd originally. My parents died when I was very young, no more than a cub. They were spice merchants, killed by bandits as we were trading on the forest roads. The elves nearby saved me afterwards. They found me hiding in a wagon and they took me in.
Ifan bites his lip.
They were my home until I was old enough to join the Order. Mother Melody always said I'd have a hard life. She saw it as fact, since I was born under the waxing moon.
He bursts out laughing.
We're two doomed peas in a pod, eh? I've been striving my whole life to prove mine wrong. To, zero success. So far. For sure. Always carry a snack.
Ifan reaches into his tunic pocket and pulls out a strip of dried raw meat. He takes a tiny bite and offers the rest to you.
Now, what else do I have to share?
Ifan rummages around the...
Uh-huh.
He hands you the mushroom with great ceremony, bowing as he holds it aloft.
Oh, I wouldn't. This one's not for eating, but I'll tell you, it comes in handy if you're dining with someone who really needs to lose their life.
Ifan smiles and looks around before reaching...
The last weapon in the lone wolf arsenal. You know, for after the toughest jobs.
He winks and
Well now, how's my favorite?
He barks a lot.
Give me work, I understand. Good company, open skies above me, and a boozy night in a tavern now and then. Only difference between being in the Order and being a lone wolf was that way back then I really believed in something, but it didn't exactly pay off. I mean, has belief ever paid off for you?
He grins wider and laughs.
You've a heart as soft as a chicken's knee. Just like mine.
This room is temperate enough. Ifan claps you on the shoulder.
Quite so, my lord. Quite so.
What?
The atmosphere in here is spooky.
You haven't ever so curious. I've picked up the scent I searched for. The cat, when it's about to pounce, isn't happy. It's her. A tale of wonderful.
She bows.
Imagine, and when I... You're only... And after it's done, you lie down in the box once more, with wet hands. You can't. The thing is, the bot. One night, it's when I'd remember him. Of course.
She bears.
Mindar and people like then. A gush. A simple. I talk. The shackle. But the sun. Oh, the sun. Ain't over yet, hun.
Just when I think this.
Still. At least.
Thank you.
is mine.
imposter. You, I am Barrel.
A lizard.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. I'm not in the mood for games.
Her smile.
Where do you think you... Well...
Her look.
Well, you should...
With a shake of her... He fixes. Then a
greeting, stranger. You know it's
he holds up the money
upstairs.
He gives you a lizard.
I'm so glad you've come. Not in the mood for games.
Her smile.
Where do you think you're going? I have a...
With a smile, she propelled...
But darling, why ever... Oh, my darling, there's no need to fret. Look, darling, I was joking. That's really not how this is supposed to work. Where do you think you're going? Wait, how about afterwards? You animal!
She stewed... He fixes. Then a
greeting, stranger. Looking to ease the pain of a decay. You know it's a...
He holds out his hand.
Oh, God. Upstairs.
Throw him in the hole for all I care.
You got that right, Hilga. You got that right.
And I'm saying, you can trust me. I can see a sorcerer from a mile away. And you can't be too careful, you know? If they can get Alexander, they can get any of us.
You're right about that. Right as rain, Hilga.
A lizard, tall.
I'm so glad you've come.
She purses her lips.
Not so fast, hotshot.
She comes to
take me.
She takes you by one ma-
Oh my.
Her world in ecstasy.
one in lovebirds. Holy hell's an undead. Again, Zara, really?
You know me, Gil. Leave him alone, Gil.
Listen, Bonebag. We're killing you and we're taking all your stuff. That's the deal. Ready?
Thank you.
darling. You're so very good at what you...
She thinks.
Do you know...
You fall in...
Boring.
He gives you a nerve.
I did promise you that's the
he bounces.
First time, eh? That'll be a hard no, dear.
He cocks his head to one side and peers appraisingly into your eyes, shrugging his shoulders.
You want an engraved invitation every time? You know the way.
I've spotted something.
Look at that. A fresh face. Lean and lovely. Like any
Ifan approaches you, a drink in his hand and a wide smile on his face. He clearly feels at home in this grimy place.
What a drink.
He grins and hands you a drink, full of good cheer.
It's really been some adventure so far, eh?
Ifan's eyebrows raise, and his cheeks color beneath his beard.
I'd say the same about you. I'm never lonely when you're around.
Ifan smiles, shyly. It's not a familiar expression on his rugged face. He inches closer to you, so close that you can feel the heat of his body warming you.
You're incredible.
He reaches out one scarred hand to touch your face, gentle as can be. Trembling, he smiles. Closing his eyes, he moves to kiss you too. Noise erupts in the under tavern around you, as patrons cheer and clap your affectionate moment. Ifan meets your eyes and laughs softly, pulling you into a bear hug.
Let's try this again sometime, when there's not quite so much company.
He squeezes your hand and winks, only moving away when he sees your answering smile.
Hail,
She drew.
Are you worthy of my gift? Indeed. This. Are you ready for me to. I can't gaze in.
She flashed. On the horizon looms a dark silhouette. As you approach, a beam of light washes the shadow away, revealing to you.
I. A kid. Most.
Dorotheus,
darling,
you draw, yet her lips do not press against yours. At a her fang.
The knowledge we part ways now. I'll. Oh my.
She kisses.
Now go. Hail.
She draw.
Are you worthy of my gift? And they say.
You step. On the horizon looms a dark silhouette. As you approach.
I will. A kiss.
Dorotheus,
darling,
you draw, yet her lips. Her fang.
You do, we part ways. Hail, dark.
She draw.
Are you worthy? And they.
You step. On the horizon looms a dark silhouette. As you approach, a beam of light washes.
I. A kiss. Most.
Dorothea sees.
Darling.
You draw. Yet her lips. Her fang.
You do. We part ways.
She draw.
Are you worthy of my g- And they say
you stay. On the horizon looms a dark silhouette. As you.
I will. A kiss.
Dorotheus,
darling,
you draw, yet her lips do not press against yours, and her hands do not caress your face. She is a woman no longer, but a were-spider.
You desire. We part ways now. I have given you what you asked, and still you'd slay me? You see, I came prepared for the occasion.
What do you want? Good. Listen up. I brought you up from...
He lived.
This oos.
The formidable...
Enough! Do you know they killed... Bart?
He sneered.
And you better have a... Brave lass. Waltz, I hope for your sake you've got good news for me. Family matter. Lucky for me. So, how'd you make it? Here's one. You one of her little seekers? Chasing down. So, what do you want? Reckon I could help you. But last I heard, you was working for the Magisters. Big shots at the boats.
An unpleasant smirk.
Right. I reckon I could help you out.
He just
had a bit of that ain't like. And wouldn't guys know? I sent. I'd like a word with the guy. Glad you see. No one. Tell him I sent you. And good. One more thing. If there's something you want to. Here. Good luck.
Careful now, that's a trap. Careful now, that's a trap.
This place stinks. But some of these barrels look interesting.
Dripping with liquid sauce inside, you find not... Behind the container.
Please. Yeah, I'm a sail. Please help me. I don't want to die. I don't want them to take me. I just need to get out of drift, please. I'll do anything. Just don't let them see me. Don't let them find me. Damn it, hurry up. I can feel the fish oozing everywhere. Okay. Go if you have to, but please be quick. If the Magisters even think that I'm here, well, we'll all be sorry. I have enough nitre and brimstone to turn this factory into a crater. Please. I don't want to die. But if the Magisters find me, I won't let them take me. I won't! Okay.
Still no sign. So, report. Did you find anything? You did? Where? He does. He must trust you if you've met him and survived.
Hey? What news?
Safe. At last, I can breathe.
At last! You have my thanks. If
I can't just soar, but once I'm sure the way's clear, I'm running to Ox like a cat with its tail on fire. I'm done with this stinking town. Oh, of course. In the kitchen. I thought she was an idiot selling it so cheap. Then again, I'm the... I swear, once I get to...
Thank you.
ghost hovers in the air. Higbar's the spirit seems confused, lost. It looks you're in darkness, bar a crack of light. You can feel cold, dead. You see the tavern. You hear the laughter of the dwarves. You hear a shout and turn. Dwarves are being pushed aside as magisters race towards you, shouting about Magister Shanda's effects. Panic fills you. You're running. The spirit twists in anguish. It desperately wants to be free. You're standing in the tavern's kitchen, hunched over a table as the chef shows you her hall, tools, seized sauce recipes, and the blade you recognize as a magister's handiwork. You open your mouth to ask a question, but she names her price. It's too low. It's too good. You can't say no. You reach for your gold. Free of your grasp, the spirit
Magister's seal. And there's blood on it.
The cook
there's nothing here for you, sister.
She grabs the ring.
Should have just kept out of this. All right.
She reaches underneath a table. Of Wivlia glares at you with all the venom she can muster.
Unless you know that, so it was an elf.
The elves.
And did you? Well, in that case. So
the elves
and well in
must be the place Lohar mentioned. It looks unassuming.
Right away.
I suppose you've heard of the disappearances around here, have you? Well, the case has been solved. Thanks.
The Magister takes...
This was a conduct of...
He stoically...
The kind that don't fancy stars.
Never finish.
Teddy for a grieving beggar whose dog ran away. God damn it. How was my...
You wouldn't do that, would you?
He gives you a...
That's your...
Keeping it together, Bree.
I'm all right, as long as I can't too much.
War's a brewing, my friend, and we may find ourselves on different sides, in which case prices will go up. Buy now while you still can.
Back for a return visit, are you?
Smells worse over here than a dozen rotten eggs dropped in a vat of vinegar.
Yep.
Glad to see you well.
For the junk you sell, then.
Junk?
Why, I offer nothing less.
Until later.
Not in any mood to talk about it.
Vapid fiction, along with the large help of it.
I would, didn't I? Sure thing.
Thank you.
want to go to Fort Joy with the smelly lizards?
The dwarf is unnaturally. She calmly.
What do you want?
The dwarf.
Who I am. Those. You know. That we both are. Get to it then.
Spotted something. There we go.
My Duna's dagger elf.
The male dwarf.
We're not looking to cause trouble. We're looking to end it. Order Sanja. Good to see you.
Only thing we managed were to close that door.
Ain't no telling where that priest was. Well, at first, then some.
She taps it.
A woman knows things. Nothing's getting past me. Best we head off then.
Thank you.
Unstuck.
Lohar will want to know of this.
Better get out there before I ask you.
He takes the bloody.
This is bad. Elifan of Court, listen up. I need your help. Look, trouble is, I ordered that. Can't happen. The less you know, that my people haven't heard. I bet my pray to whoever you pray to. They finally give me him. I don't want to know.
Thank you.
lone wolf. But did I ever tell you of my path in the divine order? Well now, how's my favorite god woken?
Looking at him, you are struck by the ease with which he lives in his body. His long, lean frame is relaxed, but his hands fidget, dexterously twirling a coin between each finger. He hums gently to himself. He turns to you in surprise. Seeing the look in your eyes, he freezes like a deer before carriage lanterns.
I don't even know how to begin to say what I want to say to you. But, you bring quite some mess into my life, and I like it.
He grins, bashful, and turns back to studio. Ifan looks uneasy, even hangdog.
Ever tell you I worked with Lucian? Fact is, I was once pretty high up in his divine order. He was a good man. And trust me, the Divine Order of today has nothing to do with Lucian's. Everything started to go downhill during the war, after my last mission.
He closes his...
You know sacrifices had to be made during the war? Well, Lucian knew he needed to use deathfog to eliminate the Black Ring. But doing that would... I was to hurry through the forests with a rift portal for the elves, so they could escape before the death fog exploded. But something went wrong. I was too late. The death fog exploded just as I arrived, and the elves were...
He shoots you a grateful look. And the smallest of smiles.
Onwards.
Like blood and death. I wonder what I've stumbled.
We're getting close. Garvin said the attack happened somewhere around here.
The cargo ought to be nearby.
Seems someone's been digging rather hastily. Something isn't right here.
The spirit notices his event.
Floyd Walker, I want his. Bring it to me. Head of the dog, Garvin. Spoil that grin. He'll got the business. Same as he did me. Rat. Pig. Find him.